Welcome to episode 10 of Cupertino Shut Up series. In this episode, we are going to implement the auth gate to check if the user is authenticated with Firebase or not to forward to the login screen or directly to the home screen. Without further ado, let's get started.
As you can see here on the My app, when we start the Shut Up application, we always go to Hello, that is the login screen. We have to implement an auth gate that will check if the user is currently logged in with Firebase or not. Forward to the home page if it is logged in. Let's go to lib. Let's create a new .dart file that will be auth. We create a stateless widget and we call it auth. Let's import Cupertino. So we call the auth gate instead of hello on the home. So for the first time when we start the application will run this widget. This widget will check if the user is authenticated with Firebase and decide to send to the login screen or to the home page of the application. Instead of returning a container, we are going to return a stream builder, and the builder will pass, we will pass the context, and the snapshot is the result of the builder, and we pass the widget we will build. So we return the container. The stream builder is a type of user. We receive a user to check if the user is the Firebase auth user we import. And then the thing we need to pass to the stream builder is the URL in which we're gonna ask for information. So for the builder, we need to pass a stream, and it will be Firebase auth instance. Each time the auth state changes, it will trigger the snapshot, and from the snapshot we can check if the user is logged in or not. Then first we need to do some checks on snapshot. If snapshot doesn't have data, it means there is no user authenticated. We can forward to the hello screen, so we return hello. Otherwise we return the home page. Let's test. I was already logged in with John previously. On the settings, I will add a logout and login. Let's go to settings, screens. We add here a Cupertino button. Child will be a text, logout, me, and on press, we call the logout. Firebase auth instance, sign out. It will sign out the current user. After we sign out, we need to send back the user to the app screen so that the auth gate gets invoked and we check again if the user is authenticated or not. So let's navigate. We log out the user and we navigate back to the main, to the app, and the app will call the auth gate to check if the user is authenticated or not to forward to the home page or to the login page. Let's go to main home page. Here is the setting screen. Let's run the application. Now we have chats, calls, people, list of people in Firestore, all these users in Firestore. We are logged in currently with John. We go to settings and we log out. Once it log out, the auth gate receives a new auth state that is changed and automatically will forward the user to the hello page. Let's log in. Let's log in with another user. So let's check Anna, edit user, and the phone number of Anna is 147. Let's get started. 147, request code, receive a code SMS from Firebase 670483, and Firebase auth knows that is already Anna that is logged in. We pick a picture for Anna, then we go to settings. We are logged in with Anna. Let's close the application. Let's open again. So we are logged in with Anna. As you can see here, we see John as a contact, as our friend, because we are logged in with Anna. We see John part of the contact. We don't see Anna anymore on the people list. We still see 5 users, as we have here on Firebase, 5 users. On Firestore, we have 5 documents as well.
That's all about this episode. On the next episode, we are going to implement infinite scrolling or lazy loading list in the people screen. Thank you for watching. See you next time.